Lil Reese shot in the eye. Hey guys, welcome back to Rap Trends. How are you guys doing? Once again, we're here with an amazing video for you guys. We try to bring you guys the latest videos on trending topics, and we never disappoint by bringing you all the best details on burning issues on the internet. In today's video, we got another trending topic, so let's get right into it. If you listen to music, or are a music lover, then you must have heard of the name Lil Reese. Tavares Taylor, popularly known by his stage name Lil Reese, is an American rapper and performing artist from Chicago, Illinois. He moved to Southern California to pursue his music career, and now that the world has become a global village with everything at the distance of a click, nothing is hidden about celebrities, from their lives to their controversies. Particularly famous amongst the young generation, and crazily followed by teenagers, Lil Reese has a huge following of approximately 1.7 million on Instagram. The news of Tavares Taylor being shot is circulating on social media, and fans are worried and not happy with this. They're concerned about his health and well-being. So if you're a true fan of 28-year-old Lil Reese, this video is for you, because in today's video we will reveal all the details of what happened with this American rap star, his life, and all the things related to this incident that occurred with him for the second time, might I add. If you want all the details, then make sure to watch the video till the end and give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to smash the subscribe button. Now let's jump right into the video. Taylor signed to one of the most famous record labels, Def Jam and the Glory Boys Entertainment. After appearing on Chief Keef's single, I Don't Like, he became famous and got a lot of attention due to the single. This was released in the year 2012. It was one of the most wrathful songs of 2012 and was a super hit single. The track paved its way to the top 20 on Billboard's Hot R&B and Hip Hop charts, and when Def Jam saw the success of this track, he announced officially that it is now a part of the label's roster. 2 days after this happened, the self-nicknamed rap star, who was at the time only 19 years old, released Don't Like. Don't Like was a mixtape, and it was hosted by the well-known Don Cannon and DJ's Drama. At the end of the year, two songs, Us and Traffic, were released by Def Jam. These songs featured fellow Windy City native Chief Keef. But unfortunately, none of these two songs made an impact as compared to the song What I Don't Like. Later in 2012, the rapper worked in collaboration with other artists such as Rick Ross and Drake to produce remix of his single Us, and the song became an instant overnight hit. It then became part of the Black Bar Mitzvah, which was Rick Ross's collaborative collection. This song opened many doors for him as he collaborated with other artists like Lil Bibby, Fredo Santana, Young Jeezy, and Twista. This was not the end of the remixes. In 2013, Tavares Taylor released another remix that was one of the hit singles, Traffic. After that, the American rap star continued to work with other artists such as Jules Santana, Lil Durk, and Fredo Santana. So in 2013 and 2015 respectively, Taylor released his two mixtapes, Super Savage and Super Savage 2. These songs were released under the label founded by Chief Keef and Fredo Santana, known as Glory Boys Entertainment, or GBE. Later in 2016, with the support from RBC, the star released another mixtape called 300 Degrees. Then, in 2019, the rap star was spotted again in a video. He was getting beat up by rival gang members. Then again, in November 2019, when Lil Reese was driving in the suburb area of Chicago, he was ambushed and two masked gunmen hit him in the neck, then fled the scene. He was taken to the hospital by a random person, and once he was in stable condition and survived the incident, he released another song just a month after. Tavares Taylor made many important accomplishments in his professional rap career. Since 2012, from a very young age, he launched 7 full-length studio albums. Then, in the year 2017 and 2018 respectively, he launched 2 other songs, Super Vultures and Normal Backwards. Then again, in 2018 and 2019, the rapper launched 2 more amazing mixtapes which were known as Get Back Gang and Get Back Gang 2. When he got very famous, then many fellow rappers collaborated with him to make guest appearances in his tracks. This was done to add more charm to the songs, to get more audience, and to get more views as well. Now, Tavares Taylor is one of the most famous and sought-after rappers in the American rap industry. Some days earlier, news was surfing in the internet that Chicago rapper Lil Reese was shot in his own hometown. According to sources like MTO News and individual reporters, Tavares Taylor was allegedly buying drugs when the incident occurred. The people who were nearby at the time have said that Lil Reese jumped into an SUV to buy drugs for himself. Before the exchange occurred, some men from a gang pulled up the SUV and were claiming or saying that the SUV was stolen from them. The man knew that Lil Reese was inside the car, but they still allegedly shot up the car. Although he was just there to do a drug deal, he had no connection or link with any kind of theft. Following the incident, a video of Lil Reese with his eye injury began to circulate the internet and went viral. According to police, there was 3 young men who were victims that were in the car garage. The ages of these men were 20, 27, and 28. It is said that the 20-year-old man was shot 2 times in the knee, but his condition was not that bad. They also also mentioned that the 27-year-old man was in a bad situation. The case seemed complicated because his condition was critical because he was shot multiple times in the body, and he was taken to Northwestern Memorial Hospital in critical condition. Talking about the third person, the police said that the 28-year-old man, who we know as Lil Reese, was grazed in one eye and that his condition was good and he was not critical as he was taken to Northwestern Hospital in fair condition. Family members of Lil Reese were extremely worried because, according to them, this is the second time that the American rapper received a bullet in his hometown of Chicago. The first case happened 2 years ago, and the rapper nearly died after being shot not too far from the Windy City. Till now, no one has been charged with the incident because of the confusing situation and lack of proper evidence against anybody present at the spot. But still, the police department is busy getting the details and building a case, so we are all waiting for the next move from the police department. It was stated by Lil Reese's family that the doctor said that the rapper is now blind in one eye, but there was some confusion after the American rap star came out calling the reports fake. He said that he was not blind at all, and went on to address his fans by saying, "Don't believe stupid things that you see on the internet." Furthermore, he explained that he doesn't know who is generating these fake stories and from where these stories are being relayed from. To wrap things up, the situation revolving Lil Reese is still ongoing and under investigation. He was lucky back then when he was shot in the neck by gunmen and managed to survive, and this time he was nearly shot in the eye, thankfully only grazed, and it was nothing less than a miracle that he survived. So what do you guys all think about this scenario, and what do you think the reason for all of this was? What was the motive? Let me know in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to like the video and ring the notification bell for more trending and hot topics happening around. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, and take care.